Father Bucky Mariano. Maraming salamat po.
Diocesan Shrine of the Virgen de la Soledad de Portabaga, Cavite City. Reverend Father Bernillo S. Mendoza, the Parish Priest and Rector of the Holy Cross Parish and Diocesan Shrine of St. Augustine, Tadza, Cavite. Spiritual Director of the Cofradía de la Virgen de la Soledad de Portabaga, Cavite. Reverend Father Antonio U. Perez, Parish Priest. Grand Marian Procession is an opportunity for us to see some of the highest examples of the Blessed Virgin of all. We see an array of forms and media, from prints to paintings to bas-relief, sculptures in the ground. We need to understand that these are representations and interpretations of one and the same persona, the Blessed Virgin Mary. As these become objects of devotion, their significance deepens. As these evolve into signifiers of pain and love, as well as history and culture. Thus, these images represent both Mary and the people who live without her. Cofradía de la Virgen de la Soledad de Portabaga Incorporated, the National Council in Cavite City, and the chapters from Poblacion, Bacoor, Patino, Bohol ng Adelo Camilo. Nakapatiran ang mahal ng Birhen ng Soledad, St. Augustine Parish, Quintes, Cavite. The Seminarians of San Jose Seminary, Quezon City. Providing us with beautiful music right now is the Maliksi Band, Pamahor, singing the people. We also have with us the Hermandad de la Imaculada Concepcion and other servers of St. John de Pumusin Parish, Malibay, Pasay City, the Devotos de la Virgen Maria San Isidro, St. Parish, St. Francis of Assisi Parish, before a Spanish sentinel on a stormy night and found the painting on canvas afloat the shores of the Cañaco Bay the next morning. On the 12th of April 1692, this image was installed on her ermita in the fortress of Portavada. In October 1883, a lady in black appeared to Governor Juan Salcedo asking to celebrate the Fiesta of the Virgen de la Soledad with the greatest pomp, so that the cholera epidemic in the province would subside. To this, the governor agreed. Catholic Church in November of 1942, and here in Manila Cathedral in Intramuros in November 1943 to 1944. His Excellency Bishop Reynaldo G. Evangelista recently approved the San Roque Parish to be the diocesan shrine of the Nuestra Señora de la Soledad de Portavada because of the fervent love and fidelity of the Virgin's devotees from all over the province and nearby towns. Her feast day is celebrated every second and third Sunday of November. Gracing the historic walled city of Intramuros today is the 350-year-old original painting of the Nuestra Señora de la Soledad de Port Havana. Inviting everyone to come and visit San Roque, Cavite City in the jubilee of the 350th anniversary of Our Lady, which started last November 10, 2017 and will last until November 18, 2018.
Viva la Vida!
Viva!
Viva la Reina de Cavite!
Viva!
Viva la Luz de Filipinas!
Viva!
Again, we wish to thank Father Dominador B. Medina, Parish Priest of Cavite City, and Father Virgilio S. Mendoza, Parish Priest of Tanza, Cavite. Serenading us now is the Tanza Municipal Band of Tanza, Cavite.